So the new batch of leaks and spoilers for Attack on Titan manga chapter 139 are finally out, and let's just say that these are going to be even more divisive. The prior leaks were already divisive enough that a lot of people were saying that this might be fake, but here this time around, I'm myself hoping that this is some sort of an elaborate prank by the leakers, and especially because this is the final chapter of AOT and they're not wanting the general public to be leaked or spoiled about the chapter before its official release. I'm at least hoping myself after reading these leaks. But that doesn't mean that the prior leaks are actually fake. I do think that the prior leaks are actually correct because it makes a lot of sense for certain characters, the case being extremely strong for Mikasa. I really think that Mikasa was handled well here, and her last scene is definitely going to be a tearjerker as such, because that was kind of foreshadowed to us in the very first ending of Attack on Titan way back in 2013. But here this time around the leaks are much more cryptic, let's just say. And this is not exactly what I was at least expecting things to be because of said reasons. Now, on my first read of these leaks, I thought that these were really trash. But after reading these leaks for a couple of times, I do realize that some of these things have been foretold to us in the past, especially in relation to the character of Reiner. But because these are simply leaks, I'm not going to give much of my opinion here at this moment, and I'm going to wait until the release of the official chapter to get the full context of the things that have been referred here. And as such, I will also request you all to please stop hating unnecessarily upon Isayama, because the official chapter is not out yet. These are simply leaks. A lot of the times these leaks are taken out of consideration and out of context, so they do not make a lot of sense. And here in the leaks itself, it is said that these leaks are very cryptic and we do not know the full context in which the things are happening here as such. But with all that being said, hello and welcome to UnderYZ, my name is Soham, and let's just jump into it. So according to the new leaks, there is a conversation that is taking place between Reiner and Sean and Peak, and I think all of these things are happening in that particular boat scene or prior to that, and I hope that this is taking place in that kind of a timescape which was teased to us in the prior leaks. Because these conversations wouldn't really make sense just after the war is over. So let's just see these leaks, and here Reiner says that Historia's handwriting is always so pretty, smells nice too. To this, John replies that, "How many times have I told you, don't have any ideas for a married woman, you are absolutely disgusting." And finally, Peak also says that, "And what are you talking about, John? Who are you trying to impress by tidying up your hair so much?" So basically, this is a friendly rant or a friendly conversation between these three characters. All these three characters have been through a lot, so I'm not exactly mad to see that they're finally having a peaceful time as such. But there's certainly more to all of this, because at first I thought that why is Reiner suddenly talking about Historia? But on second thoughts, I remembered season 2 of Attack on Titan, where Reiner clearly showed that he definitely had feelings for Historia. They might not be exactly romantic as such, but he definitely had feelings for Historia, or rather Krista at that moment, because she was only one of those very few characters who was totally able to understand the character of Reiner as such and the predicament that he was currently at. Again, I'm going to elaborate on all these things once the chapter is officially out, so please stay on hold until then. But moving forward, there's a very lame joke. I was not expecting this sort of a lame joke here, at least for the finale of Attack on Titan. And probably this is one of the major reasons why a lot of fans are quote unquote pissed off, but once again, let's just wait for the official chapter. But here John says that, "For all the schoolgirls who'll read the history books." And Reiner to this replies that, "History books? Don't you mean those horse encyclopedias?" I mean, really, a horse joke in the final chapter of AOT. This is not something which we were expecting, but okay, I guess we have to go with it. And John finally says that, "The fact that a trash like you prolonged his life makes me deeply sad." And this is the end of the first part of the leak, and the second part of the leak says that Eren has actually manipulated the memories in Armin for a long time ago. Eren wanted to be a big bad kind of a guy, and he wanted them to kill him actually, and this is one of the major motivations throughout the entirety of season 4 of Attack on Titan. And this is kind of reminding me of Lelouch as well as Sasuke Uchiha during the end of the war. All these things are kind of like an idealistic standpoint where these characters are going to take the hatred of the entire world upon themselves and show themselves as the big bad guy so that the entire world can kind of unite against them. It's flawed, it's absolutely a flawed concept, but let's just go with it. And also it says here that this memory will only be activated after his death. So this is definitely the power of the founding titan, and here basically Eren wanted himself to make the big bad villain so that after his death, Armin, Mikasa and the others do not suffer for him, and rather they always remember him to be a big bad villain as such. This is basically like a meme at this point. I don't even know how to react to this. I'm not inherently saying that this is bad or anything like that, but it's just not as something which we were expecting to see, basically like that. And lastly, it says here that Levi might not be able to see from his right eye ever again. So that's kind of okay or justifiable after all the damage that Levi has taken so far. It's all right in my opinion. So these are currently all the second batch of leaks that we currently have for Attack on Titan chapter 139. We will obviously have to wait for the official chapter before we give a full in-depth explanation or thoughts and opinions about it. So please stay tuned till then. Please do mention your thoughts in the comment section below. So that's it for today guys. Thank you so much for watching. Please give this video a thumbs up if you like it. Share it with your friends and subscribe to our channel for more. This is WonderYZ and I'll see you soon on the next one.